Google is rolling out a brand new AdWords interface, and by 2018, everyone who is using AdWords will have this new AdWords interface. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up a brand new campaign in the new interface. Hello, my name is Ozair and thanks for joining in. So this is the new AdWords interface. If you haven't seen it yet, you will get one very soon, and by early 2018 everybody will be on this new interface. Whether you like it or not, that's besides the point, but this is here to stay. My first initial reaction to this is I personally don't like changes, so I'm not used to it right now, but eventually it's growing on me, and I quite like the clean feel and look of the new interface, and it's growing on me. So you can go back to the old interface because some of the features are not on the new one yet, and they should roll out very soon. But let's show you how to set up a brand new campaign in the new interface. So all you do is, before we start the campaign, let me show you how the interface is laid out. So you've got all the usual links and buttons on the left hand side, campaign, ad groups, and so on. And whenever you want to create a new ad, campaign, or add a new keyword, the plus sign gets clicked and you will open up a new window. But before I do that, let me go on to the top right hand corner, and these three little dots open up a sub menu where you have all your keyword planner. So the display planner is not here at the moment, as you can see. Shared library, we've got all the bulk actions and the conversions analytics, and obviously your setup. One thing which a lot of people are freaking out by at the moment is this message which is popping up in everybody's account, that the daily budgets now have more flexibility, and to help you hit your advertising goals, like clicks and conversions, your campaigns can now spend up to twice your average daily budget. Don't freak out, because your overall monthly budget will not go over the limit. If you've got a monthly budget in mind, don't stress and freak out that, oh my God, I'm going to spend more than double my budget. Google won't do that. And if they do, then you won't get charged. So nothing to worry about. It's just that if Google finds that some of your clicks can get more conversions on a particular day, then they are going to let the campaigns running, which is good for you as well as for Google. So I wouldn't worry too much about it. Okay, so let's go and create a new campaign. So I click on the plus button. You get your five different campaign types: search, display, shopping, video, and for the apps. So we're gonna concentrate on the search campaign for this video. Click on that. Then what you want to do: visit your website or get someone to express interest on your website, buy on your website, or call your business. In this video, we're going to concentrate on the search network, and I'm gonna click on here, which is the express interest on your website. You enter your business website address, but that's optional, but I'm going to enter it. Continue. Okay, then you name your campaign. I'm just going to call this test. Okay. Now, I personally uncheck these buttons, because when I am running a search campaign, I only want the ads to go on the Google search page and not on the Google search partners, neither on the Google display network. This is quite important, especially the second one. A lot of people include this, within the same campaign. If you do want to run a text campaign on the GDN, then I would highly recommend that you set up a brand new campaign or a different campaign to the search campaign. So you will have two campaigns running, one for the search network and one for the GDN. So always uncheck that, because you have a lot more flexibility when it comes to bidding and placement as well. Okay, now depending on where you want to show your ads, I'm just going to enter it my local radius around 5 mile radius of where we are. Okay, now I can save that. I'm happy with that. Language is obviously English. Now you have the choice for the bidding. I always start with a manual CPC and I uncheck the enhanced CPC button as well. Daily budget could be anything. It could be £10 or £5 or £20 per day. It depends on you. Delivery method, I tend to keep it as standard because I don't want all the budget to be used up early part of the day and my ads won't show across the whole day. So I'm going to keep it standard. Start date, which is today. I don't tend to set an end date, but if it is a very specific, a time specific campaign, then sure, you can enter it. So if you were running a campaign for, let's say, Christmas, or it was an campaign for an event, so you don't want to run the ads after the event has finished, so you can set up the end date as well. Site link is extremely important, and I would always recommend that you use up as many site links as you possibly can. So I'm going to check all of these and enter them. Same with the callout extensions. Extensions are extremely important when it comes to your quality score and the CTR, because it makes your ads a lot bigger with all these extensions. So you get more clicks, your CTR go higher, your quality score increases, and your cost per click goes down. So I'm gonna add that callout extension, and obviously I'm going to put in my call extension, which is my phone number. And once I've done all that, I save it and my campaign has been set up. So this is how you set up a campaign in the new AdWords interface. I hope you enjoyed this video. I'd really appreciate if you would subscribe, like, share, comment for this video, and I look forward to seeing you on the next one. Till then, bye for now.